Can't run from me.
This is Mr. New Vegas fanning the flames of your passion. Here are our top stories. The Helios 1 solar power plant remains dormant despite NCR's effort to reactivate the facility. The chief scientist at the plant vowed to fix the problem, blaming it on an atmosphere of, quote, severe underappreciation. Moving on. Scavengers report hulking individuals moving around Hidden Valley after dusk, but have been unable to identify them due to low visibility. Those were our top stories. In New Vegas, we know the pain that numbers can bring us. Well, so does Guy Mitchell, who's got heartaches by the number.
Is the way clear? Praise the Creator, and bless you, Wanderer. The way is clear. I will lead my flock through the basement to the sacred site. I hope you will come find us there, Wanderer. There is much to be done. I waited to speak with you one last time before I descended to the launch pad, Wanderer. I want you to know that we will remember for all eternity how you delivered us to the threshold of the Great Journey. Our preparations are nearly complete, but the rockets that will carry us to salvation are yet missing vital components. If you would still help us, Wanderer, speak to Chris. He can tell you what is missing. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always. Yes, the rockets will convey us to our promised land in the far beyond. Vision upon vision has confirmed it. I understand your concerns, friend, and I thank you for voicing them. But the Creator's will for us has been made manifest. I have glimpsed it only in visions, Wanderer, but what I have seen is truly miraculous. It is a place of light and healing, and I know in my soul that my flock will be safe there. After all that you have done for us, I suppose you deserve to know everything. When Chris came to us, we tried to convince him that he was human, but this only angered him. He seemed lost. We decided to let him stay with us for a few days, over the course of which we learned that his technical skills far surpassed our own. It became clear that the Creator had sent him to us to ensure the success of the Great Journey. Equally clear was that Chris should labor in blessed ignorance of his humanity and his inability to make the journey himself. It is no coincidence that two humans have been vital to the success of the Great Journey. It is my belief that the Creator sent you and Chris to expiate the sins of your kind against mine. Your Redeemers both. Such is the Creator's will. Vision upon vision has shown me that were Chris to accompany us, he would die in minutes. The radiation around the launch pad alone would kill Chris in minutes. The radioactivity of the far beyond is much stronger. Chris shall be declared the saint of the Great Journey before we depart. I hope this will ease his sadness. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always. Forgive me, Wanderer, but my flock awaits. There is no way that we can thank you.
Hey. Jason says that I am to cooperate with you on the final tasks necessary to launch the Great Journey. I'm the flock's resident engineer. I've always been good with machines. Jason says the Great Journey would have been impossible without me. Of course, my skills aren't much use unless I have the right materials. That's where you come in. When I joined the flock, Jason made it clear that he wanted me to supervise the repairs, not do them myself. It would be a waste of my gifts to work on just one system at a time. From up here, I've been able to supervise the entire project. I thought we were past all that, Smoothskin. But you just can't resist the chance to mess with me. Typical human. I was human once, you know. Grew up in Vault 34, northeast of here. Nice upbringing if you like assault rifles and target practice. But oh, you prefer machines that don't shoot people? Not so nice, then. Who should maintain the vault's reactor? Hauser? Mitchell? No! Make it Haversom. He likes machines. Haversom won't mind getting irradiated. Haversom won't mind mutating. He's already ugly as it is. Haversom won't mind when his hair starts falling out after a few years. There's no connection, Haversom. You're neurotic. Bald? You call this bald, Smoothskin? I'm a monster. A monster! Oh, God. You're telling me the truth, aren't you? Oh, no. How could they do this to me? For 2 years? My God, I've been a joke to them. Do you have any idea how easy it'd be for me to sabotage those rockets? That'd be a joke, huh? One hell of a joke. Then bring me sugar bombs. 3 boxes should do the trick. Add those to the fuel mixture and boom! I'll show those rotten ghouls, and they'll know exactly who did them in. I said I need 3 boxes of sugar bombs, not less than 3. To sabotage the rockets, I'll still need to get them ready for launch. I still need a quantity of the igniting agent and the thrust control modules. For the fuel source, any shielded nuclear waste should do the trick. That's why we can't use the waste on the launch pad. Too much decay. As for the computer parts, the thruster control systems aren't complicated, so any good mix of components is all I need. Very well, we don't need a huge amount. 2 to 3 liters should be enough. Repcon has been ransacked so many times by scavengers, it's hard to know where the components might turn up, if they turn up. Jason has mentioned some industrial ruins to the east that are supposed to be highly radioactive. Later. Thank you.
Love me as though there were no tomorrow.
Welcome to the Dino Bite Gift Shop. My name's Cliff. If you're here for the T-Rex... I don't really know. Would that sour you on buying one if it did? Well, there's T-Rex figurines, of course. That's our bread and butter. We also have an assortment of the Repcon factory souvenirs, rockets, things of that nature. They're scale replicas of the real thing. Very detailed. Got a liquid in them that makes them glow. From what I hear, Repcon used to give them out on tours of their HQ up in Henderson. But I guess they had to stop after the first few kids thought they were filled with Nuka-Cola and drank it down. The papers had a name for the condition and everything. They called it the Repcon Shakes. Those were bad times for Robco. Well, they unloaded what they had left on the Dino Bite as a tax write-off, but that was before my time. Plenty of demand for them, seeing as how they're one-of-a-kind collector's items, but I might still have some in back. Really? I never thought I'd see the day. I mean, the day I'd part with them for such an incredibly low price, with so many other offers flooding in. But I like you. I think maybe it's time. All that's left is in the storage room here. You can buy the key from my store. Okay, I admit it. They've been collecting dust since before I got here. You can have them dirt cheap. Sure thing. Have a look.
Guns?
I guess.